Police believe the group of young people had initially gathered at Waterfront to remember a murder victim when the violence started Saturday night.
WLKY's Annalisa Gale is live at the Parkland Boys and Girls Club, where community leaders are working on ways to prevent this from happening again. Annalisa?
Rick, Vicki, the closed meeting here at the Parkland Boys and Girls Club just wrapped up a few minutes ago, where community leaders were discussing ways to prevent what we saw downtown between the waterfront area and the downtown central business district, that is. This is just one of the pamphlets that was handed out. It says community violence reactions and actions in dangerous times. Following a weekend of assaults in the downtown area, a community is coming together to reach out to young people, the demographic believed to be mostly involved in the wave of weekend crime.
And we were called in to try to give some support to the youth in the neighborhood after recent violent events.
Today, Mayor Greg Fisher called the behavior by the youth unacceptable. Police Chief Steve Conrad believes the violence may be related to an incident last week when teenager McQuell Offit was stabbed on a TARC bus. He died 2 days after the attack.
People were coming to the park to remember their friend. Somewhere, things went bad. We ended up getting our first call for service at 7:23.
What we're interested in is people that are ready to be part of the solution. It's easy to be a critic from the couch.
Cynthia Wright is a coordinator with the Kentucky Community Crisis Board. She says she is part of the solution here at the Parkland Boys and Girls Club.
What we'll do is talk with them about, you know, this is pretty bad stuff that's happened. It's pretty upsetting, and anybody would be upset. There's a lot of reactions that we can have from that as human beings.
19-year-old Kelsey Goff says scenes like this one captured outside of a Bader's Food Mart this weekend is something she has seen before among her peers.
I've seen it before, but I try not to go around it.
She proposes a solution of her own.
Maybe some alternatives for people my age, so like instead of just running around at the waterfront.
I thought that this weekend was appalling and it was scary. And at the same time, our response can be a bit scary as well if what we're saying is profile young black men, because I don't want another Jordan Davis or Trayvon Martin in Louisville, Kentucky.
Today at the meeting with the mayor, it was stressed that this issue is not black and white, because victims of this weekend's assault were both of both races. Tomorrow at the Urban League, young women and young men will also meet again to discuss possible solutions. Live at the Boys and Girls Club here in the Parkland, Annalisa Gale, WLKY News.